The mistake I made yesterday is that those two big nuts up there, are the mains. But I should have wired into that screw on the left and that screw, you can kind of see it, the black wire, if you follow it, coming out of where the white wire is with the fuzzy. Yeah. Alright, so you can see the video quality is a lot better. I finally got my replacement phone. We're a little bit of the ways in, and at least according to the gauges, this battery was close to full, looks like. I mean, this guy reads two or three above him, which, you know, who knows. Neither one of them is crazy expensive, although this one was $40. But here's where we are. He's making a little bit of a high-pitched whine. I don't know if the mic's picking it up. I don't think that that's out of the ordinary. And the nice people over at Green Hybrid Forums told me I probably could do better for the airflow than just that fan, so I've destroyed a 40-gallon trash bag and made a makeshift shroud. Just basically making a triangle. I got the two ends underneath here. I cut one side top to bottom. And very technical device right there. But when I feel back here, it's not uniform airflow, but it's definitely not just air coming from over here and coming around. So even though I'm not getting all of it, I feel good about it. And here we are, like a couple hours in, we're at 172, and this guy's output has slowly been coming down. It was flipping between 35 and 36 when it started. Now it's down to 34. It's probably a tiny amount of deviation, really. I'm just afraid that if I do anything to mess with this guy, since the current's actually traveling through it, that I could blow something up. I'm probably wrong, but I don't want to risk it. So here we are. Very conducive to airflow. Oh yeah. This one's just slowly climbing. They say that once it gets to a certain point, it'll like level off, and then I'll feel more heat coming out of there, and that it'll actually go up a couple and then come down a couple as the chemistry inside the cells kind of resets. So here we are, 10:30 the next day, and I look to have lost most of what I got yesterday, because it started at 166-ish yesterday, and that's right about where he was again today. Much sad. It's mostly because I was afraid that this didn't want to trust it unattended for 8 hours while I slept. So that's that, I guess. Still curious what the heck this tape is all about. It's just scotch tape. Yours come from the factory like that? The nice people at greenhybrid.com forums told me that the bulbs I was using were, I mean, there wasn't anything wrong with them, but it was going to take forever to run all this through 260 watts in series. They explained to me that you put them in series because it greatly reduces the risk that you explode one of them, because that would be bad. Not so much explode it, but blow the filament, and then you're down until you replace it and have no no greater chance that the next one won't blow too. So let's see what happens with my two 90 watt spotlights. Hey! Yeah, we're at 169. Which, I guess that's okay. It's right at the top end of operating voltage. And we're draining about 610 milliamps.